am going to take present tense and tense. Already we saw past tense. Now we're going to see present tense. Okay. A tense expressing an action that is currently going on or habitually performed or a state that currently or generally exists is called present tense. Okay. Simple present. Simple present is used mainly over here. Habits and routines, permanent situation, facts and states. These are the areas where simple present is used. Okay. Present simple tense. How to write a present simple tense? Okay. Subject plus verb. Okay. What is subject? I, he, she, you, we, they. Even names or come under subject. Names like Kavita, Rahul. Okay. Like that. What is verb? Verb is a action word. What is verb? Verb is a action word. Okay, give me some example for verb. Drink, eat, run. These are all come under verb. Okay, shall we form a sentence? Okay, children. Present simple tense. Present simple tense. What I told you, children, where and all the present simple tense is used? First one is habits and routines. Okay, let us take a timeline, children. Okay, now we are currently present in Thursday. Okay, let us assume we are in a Thursday. Okay, I drink coffee every morning. Okay, I drink coffee every morning. Okay, the sentence means I used to drink coffee every morning. Whether it's today or Wednesday, Tuesday, Monday or this Friday, Saturday, Sunday, it's a habit. I used to drink coffee daily. It is a habit and a routine. So I used to write I drink coffee every morning. Okay, you should not write I drinking coffee. This means a continuous tense. Okay, you should not. It doesn't make any sense. Okay, this is I drink coffee every morning. Okay, this only means a simple present tense. Okay, if you write I drinking coffee every morning, this is a long tense. Okay, next, Ramu visits parent. Ramu visits his parent every week. Here, you should write Ramu visits his parents every week. Ramu is subject, visits is a verb, his parents every week. This is simple present tense, okay? First we saw habits and routines.
So here comes habit and routines. These words express that the sentence, the event, the action which is takes place in habits or in a routine. Okay, every morning, every evening, every night, every day, every week, every year. This sentence will express the thing, the action is takes place in a habitual. Second one, on Sundays, on Friday, in summer, in winter, in spring. Okay, once a week, once a month, twice a week, twice a year. The sentence will express the sentence is in a habitude. The action which takes place in a habit and routine. Ramu visits his parents once a week.
Now we are going to see a second usage of present simple tense. What is the second usage? It is used in a permanent situation. Okay, let us take a timeline. I'll give you a sentence. Nandu lives in Delhi. This sentence explains that Nandu lives in Delhi. His habitat is in Delhi. He is not going to change his place. This is a permanent condition. I live in Chennai. Okay, this is a permanent condition. I'm not going to change. This is a permanent condition. Okay. Okay. Let us take another sentence. Okay. Nandu speaks Hindi.
mother tongue is Hindi, and this is a permanent situation, Hindi. He going to speak Hindi. Okay, Nandu lives in Delhi, Nandu speaks Hindi. These are all the permanent situation. We cannot write Nandu living in Delhi. It means it has a present continuous tense. We cannot write Nandu lives in Delhi. We can tell my brother living with me for past 2 years. Okay, here the sentence explains it is a continuous tense. So this doesn't come under present simple tense. Present simple tense usage is only to be under a permanent situation. Okay, Nandu lives in Delhi. Nandu speaks Hindi. Like this, it should be a permanent form. The third usage of present simple tense is facts. Facts means what? It's about telling a GK issue. You know about the general knowledge thing, right? Right, children? It will not change under any condition. Okay, this is like a habitude, or you can take it as a permanent or whatever you want. Okay, past, present, future. This condition happening and will also happen. Like the capital of India is Delhi. Okay, this is a permanent situation or habitude or whatever you can say. Okay, birds fly. Okay, birds will always fly. It is a permanent thing. It is a habitual thing. 2 plus 2 equals to 4. This will never change. It is a permanent situation. Okay, 2 plus 2 equals. Okay, here you can see the verb. Okay, children. Here comes the fourth usage of present simple tense. What is fourth usage? State words. Okay, let us take an example. I want an ice cream. Here, it is expressing our wants and likes. Okay, here you should write I want an ice cream. You cannot write I wanting an ice cream. If you write I wanting an ice cream, that the tense doesn't make any sense. Okay, the sentence itself doesn't give any meaning. I think she has an ability to do. Okay, over here, it is expressing opinions and thought. Okay, what is state word, children? State word means expressing opinion and thoughts and also expressing wants and likes. Okay, it is called state word, children. Here you cannot add ing over here. If you add ing over here, it doesn't make any sentence, any sense, children. Okay, now you understood? Okay,
children, let us do a quick recap of present simple tense. Usage of present simple tense. Where and all we will use present simple tense? Habits and routines, permanent situation, facts, and state words. Okay, give me an example for habits and routines. Where will we use habits and routines? Okay, I drink coffee every morning. Okay, this will come under habits and routines. Permanent situation, I live in Chennai. My brother lives in Africa. Okay, these are all come under permanent situation. The situation where we cannot change. It is a habitat situation. Facts. Okay, a birds fly. Okay, these are all facts. A tiger is carnivorous. Okay, state words. I want an ice cream. Like this. Okay, children.
Today we saw present simple tense. I think this will be useful for you. If you have any doubt needs, you can come under comment section. I will help you out. Thank you, children.